Let's just start with the drill. We're gonna be home guard. So when we start off a match, if you go for a grip, like it depends on what kind of competition you're doing, but a lot of times when you start off a match, as soon as I get a grip, he's gonna get a grip, or as soon as he gets a grip, he's just gonna sit down. Yeah, it happens all the time. As soon as the guy gets a grip, he just pulls his guard super fast. They wanna be the first one to their butt, okay? I want to avoid doing that and try and get a tournament coming up. I know it's not quite IBJJF rules, so we have a lot of time people kind of wrestle around on the feet, and we have a good chance to get grips, okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to go off of just a double sleeve. We're both going to grip up. Boom, when he gets his grip, I'm going to focus on this, put that foot in the hip and do my guard, okay? Real quick, I'm not using my right foot in because I'm controlling this sleeve, I'm not controlling this sleeve. So if I put this foot in the hip, he's gonna grab it and run me down, okay? So I'm not gonna use that. Like, in judo, you use this foot if you're gonna do a throw, okay? It's because we're exploding, it's a little bit different. So here I'm gonna put this left foot in, I'm gonna try and bend him over. So I'm gonna put my foot in, I'm gonna push it into his hip, and I'm gonna pull him. Pulling him, I'm gonna keep my hands close. Now, see how close this left hand comes to my body? I'm gonna keep it sucked in close to me so that when I fall, he's holding me up. Unless he face plants himself, he's not going to, I'm not gonna take a hard fall, okay? So get the grips, I put my foot in the hip. I'm gonna start to sit down. I'm gonna start to swing open this way, okay? So as I sit, I pull him in, and I use the grips to give myself a light fall, okay? And this foot swings open this way. Now I'm just gonna come two to his sleeve, okay? So I have the one on the sleeve, I'm gonna come the other one like a spider guard grip, here, and to his ankle, okay? I'm gonna just go our tripod sweep. So I'm this like swung out, I want that, because this momentum of swinging out pulls him over me. And now, boom, boom, and I swing back in, hook, kick hard, pull, and this doesn't have to do a lot of pulling, just hook, pull hard with your hand, and kick hard with your foot. Pull yourself up with the sleeve here. Okay, so I like to come right up on the sleeve. Notice I hit my butt, my foot is here over his body. What people do a lot is they throw this like over here, and they try to get up into some kind of half guard. He's got a hand on the ground. This knee's gonna come right into my chest as I try to get up. Boom, okay? So I have to come, don't have to, but I have to do a different stand-up. So from here, I can either post the hand that is on the sleeve, not the leg, because the sleeve doesn't keep him down, but the foot will. If his foot's off the ground, he can't get up, okay? So keep the foot off the ground, post my hand, and do a technical stand-up. Okay, then we can leg drag him if you want. Or, from here, swing, grip, here, sweep, or like I like to do, I just bring both feet in, and holding on to him, as long as I keep that grip close still, it's pulling on me. It's pulling my upper body up, so it's like I have a weight in front of me or somebody pulling me up. I can easily stand up to my feet here and then go forward, okay? So I like to carry it like that. Get my grips, foot in the belt, start to sit. Don't sit without your grips. Pull those into your chest. Now sit down. It's a nice, easy sit, okay? Two to the sleeve, go to the heel. Swing my foot behind the knee. I'm gonna kick with that foot on the belt and pull the heel. Bring the feet in and stand up. Okay, because now I'm in a position, I can easily just cut right over and start to make position here. As soon as he goes down, he can leg drag across, okay? So one more time, we get grips. Boom, I'm gonna put foot in the hip. Sit, come to his sleeve, come to his heel. Swing, boom, and up, okay? Now I'll have my partner up. And you'll do the same to me, and we'll go back and forth, one for one. Okay. So we're going to go now, if tripod isn't what you're looking for, maybe you can tell sometimes when you pull guard on somebody, they're really strong, or that's not the game to go for. Tripod's a nice basic sweep. It gets us to a position. If you can get to that tripod sweep position, now you're in a position to kind of play. It's just that even if you can't see well here, if you watch the video later,
it's common sense.
So from here, I hate telling people that, it'll make me feel bad, man. No, so here, pull guard, swing open, okay? Now, I'm gonna come to just kind of, I could come to just a normal open guard here, okay? Instead of swinging back and going foot behind, here, okay? I could be here and just a normal open guard. I might load him up to try to go over me, grab a double ankle sweep here. Okay, this is all really, really good. But I like to come here when I come to this guard and make a grip break. Okay, so I like to take both sleeves to his sleeve right here, like we were gonna go here. But instead of coming to the heel now, I break the grip. So I come to my open guard, I break, boom. I'm gonna punch it with my right hand. So this is cross grip, right? Same side grip, cross grip. Make sure we're in a cross grip here. I'm gonna swing this leg open, like how I was going tripod here, boom. Both feet on hips. This one's gonna come around, and I'm gonna sit up, okay? Use my weight, shoot him through, and sit up, punch this between. Okay, I like to come here. My head goes right into the shoulder. Don't be on the outside of the leg. Make sure, yeah, he'll take my back, just walk right around, okay? So, when I sit up, be right here in front of it. Head can come here, this is not dangerous. It feels like you're under his arm or something. I'm controlling, I'm fine. Just don't be behind the leg, okay? So coming in front. Now I recapture the grip the same way. So if you pulled guard and you had a funky grip, okay, you came to both break it. When, if I have a weird grip, like something like here, okay, when I sit up, I'm not gonna have a good grip on his sleeve. I don't wanna do this thing and try and hug it. He's just gonna posture out. There's no holding that, okay? So I wanna have this grip. I have time when I pull guard here. Boom. I have time to come feet on hips and grab another good grip here. Okay, good spider guard kind of grip. And now break it. I need these grips to break it. Okay? Now I come. Swing right up and punch between the legs. Grip. Same spider grip. Okay, so turn this a little bit here. Four fingers in the rolled back cuff. Okay? Here. This is not going to let go now. Okay? If they go into a mode where you feel like they're going to posture out and break your grip, control, after you get here, control his collar. Because now I can go down with this, and so this isn't strong. Okay? Don't go too here and try to keep it because he's going to posture still. It might get too strong, so come to the collar here. Okay? You've got little space measures you can make with your foot if you want. But once we have his sleeve between, we usually act pretty quick. Okay? So I've got a couple moves I like to do. One is I'm going to post my foot and my hand back like a picture frame, and I'm going to come to an S stretch. Not this way where my head wants to go outside of his legs. This way, going through between his legs, okay? Head stays in front. I'm going to use my hand, push my belly into his knee really hard, belly and chest, so that I can get up into a single leg, okay? Boom. Here, okay? I like to grab this, and it's a normal single leg finish, turn, let me tie it. Okay, keep his sleeve if you want. You can let it go, but I like to keep it and start to leave him one side to smash, okay? So from here, it's looking long. It's not, as long as we remember our first technique, boom, come here, break in here, okay? Get a good grip. Now there's two things we do here. Notice how my legs are? That's why I don't take the time to come back to a normal sitting guard here. When I sit up, I'm here, I can just keep driving through. Either drive my chest into it and just take him down on my butt, here, boom. Or if I can't, they've got good balance and they're hopping, this is when I stand up. Okay, hold the heel and take him down. Number three, on this near sleeve, is spinning under him, okay? If he can't post his hand, then I'm just going to kind of go to like a half guard. Pull him into a half guard type movement. Put my wrist under his ankle and start to turn. And I can't leave my legs flat here. I need to keep my knee up by my body. If I leave my leg flat, he's going to put his knee on the ground over here next to me and just smash me. Okay? That knee won't ever go there if there's this wall here. Okay? So I'm in my single leg position, especially here if I can't take him down, there's too much pressure. I just come here, bring this knee up here, now spin through. There's no hand for him to post, so just keep twisting. Okay? All the way up. Here. It's my favorite one from this position that I show the single leg takedowns first, because those are more fundamental, okay? We have to be sharp on our fundamentals. Break, punch with the cross grip hand. People get mixed up a lot going here. Make sure we don't go there, okay? Make sure we punch cross grip hand. Re-grip, solid. Boom, take your time to get that grip, okay? Now, if things feel close to you here, you can't just put your foot here, but you can push your hand away, okay? This is a good instant thing to do. I make my grip and I push the hand so I have some space, okay? Now I can throw it behind me and drive in for my single leg, or I can spin under. Okay. Oh, nice.
Sorry.
Now you're good? You're just breaking your own posture for me. So here, boom, boom. Okay. Bad enough. Grab your partner, guys. So another concept of this move, I want to point out really quick before I do it. I don't usually like throw it from this same combo of grip setups, okay? But I use the game I'm about to show a lot. It's almost the same exact technique. When we're here, when I get this grip broken, what we're going to end up with is we're going to come to this game on his far sleeve or on the belt or the pel, okay? So what it is I don't get there from this sleeve because if I was here and I broke this collar, that would require swinging up to this far leg. Realistically, he just steps that foot back and he's past my body. So I don't go that way to set up this game. Usually what happens is you might be in a de la hiba, some kind of, and he may control my pants something here. And now I can kick him away, break that grip, boom, and sit up. Okay, so with de la hiba, remember where I kicked to on this game, the legs between my legs, and I just need to sit up and get that knee in my chest. That's all I'm doing here. So we can be in de la hiba, and I can reach up and grab a belt. Okay, now all I have to do is kick him away with my free leg, and sit up, okay, and hang this through. All right, so we have the same position. Like I said, very common de la hiba that he has in my pants. He's trying to pass, controlling the free leg. Just break here, boom, push him away, same thing, sit up. So we sit up by bringing this leg to the ground now and letting go of the leg. If you're flexible, you can keep this foot here for distance control. If not, you can swing up without it, okay? But I'm gonna come to this sleeve, and here's why I teach this sleeve with the belt and with the lapels, posture, right here, okay? Any of these. The reason I teach these together and separate from this sleeve, even though the game looks the same, is because when I back roll on this sleeve, he can't make a post. So this game, it's always gonna look the same if I have like a belt or anything from here. When I have this, I'll try to keep your straps up.
I'll just do it.
When I have this, this is, be lucky I'm not using like Greco-Roman.
Yeah, I'm getting a little lower.
So from here, so these techniques probably worked back then. But from here, I'm gonna push into him. I have both of my same attacks, so I'm trying for single leg, and single leg doesn't change because he can't post his hands anyway standing up like this. So single leg works the same. I either push into him, I stand up into it, okay? Like picture frame takedown, or if he's hopping for balance, go ahead and hop back, then I stand up, okay? Everything's the same with single leg. With my backspin, he's got two hands. So this is why I teach it differently. If I'm on this sleeve, backspin works like 99% of the time. If I'm on the middle grips or the far sleeve, he's got this post. If I'm on the middle grips, he's got both. Okay? But the fact is that if I back roll, he's got a post up to keep from going down. Now what this is, I want this. This little hole right here. Okay, so I kept my knee up so that his knee can't slide into my armpit. Because I've got to keep his knee on my body so that I can roll back. So my hand was here, and I tried to roll one way, didn't work. I'm gonna push his pant leg away, so we'll turn it over here. I'm gonna push his pant leg away, and I'm gonna roll back up. When my head pops out, okay? So I call this the hey now game. Because he goes, hey now, I'm gonna grab the grip. But that's what we call it for a long time now. So here, anytime I get a hangout grip and I'm gonna spin under, if it's here or far sleeve, I know he's posting, I'm spinning under, knowing I'm spinning back. I'm never spinning under thinking this guy's going down.
Boom. I'm never actually gonna sweep him this way. I'm spinning this way to swim,
spin this way and pop my head up. Okay? We always know with this grip or with the far sleeve that we're spinning to spin back. We can't just spin one way, okay? So that's why I teach it separately. With this sleeve, boom, we break, come here. If I spin through here, he's gonna fall. Okay? Because that hand's not enough. We're taking him towards this corner. It's not quite enough. Okay? Sometimes with the far sleeve, you can get yourself, so like we're in Danahiva, got the little setup. Yeah, exactly. You can come here, boom, kick away, sit up, catch. Okay? And sometimes in Danahiva, with the far sleeve, when I backspin, he posts this hand, but it's not enough. And I feel that I can just turn him, and eventually I'll push him to his butt. Because I have this, so I kind of lifted his pant leg. I'm kind of grabbing and really bench pressing him off the ground. And now turning, eventually I get him down, okay? But that's only with the far sleeve even, and even that, it's pretty rare. It's smartest by far to plan for either the hangout here or far sleeve that I spin under, knowing he's gonna stop it when I swing back. Post the hand, come up under, okay? The other thing is, when you come here, almost every time, invariably, they're going to go to this far hip because he doesn't want me getting his back. He's just gonna go to his guard. So I end up just being on top in the same position, okay? So do it with spinning to your guard, coming up. So break, I kick away, come to this position. Now when I spin under, he posts, I come back, and he just goes right down. This is usually what happens because he knows as I start to take the back, he has to. If your back's on the mat, you can't be taken, okay? So they throw the back flat to the mat to at least be playing guard and not have their back, okay? So we're gonna play this game really quick one time. Let's set it up just from Danahiva so we have some context. Then if we, if somebody ends up in Danahiva and they don't have a lot of moves from there, you'll have a little something, okay? So from here, you can have this. Remember, if he's no grips, go ahead and go gripless and posture. I kick him away, sit up, and get belled for lapel, okay? Now, here's where we get a sleeve while we're playing this game. These are always here. You're always get this grip. If he goes to break it, now I can choose which hand I want. So if he goes to break it, I can play far sleeve, boom. If he goes to break it, I can play near sleeve. So I don't have to set up near sleeve from the guard pull. I can get my normal hand out, boom, he wants to break it. However he goes, boom, can't get this one. I can do my backspin the way I liked it. With a full sweep. Okay? So let's, one more time here. Danahiva, break if he's here. If he's not there, or if he's just, yeah, kick away, sit up. Get a hangout grip. If he goes to pull it out of your hand or anything, then we can still go with the other game. Boom. Okay? But from here, we do our single leg. And we try to back roll. He posts. Once he posts, back roll back up. Either you'll take his back, boom, or just sit. Exactly. Okay? Grab your partner, guys. It's the same game that we played on the last grip. We're gonna work more sitting guard this week, but I wanna go some from shin to shin also, okay? So we're in a position here, whichever grip we get, I like this one a lot. So we're in a position here, where I'm fighting, I can put a foot for space, I can put the palm first, and then I have long arms and short legs, so I can straighten it, and then my foot can just go ahead of it. Okay, but from here, I'm in a position where I can play a lot of things. Our basic combo is that single leg backspin, okay? But I can also, from here while I'm pressuring or doing things, post a hand. It's like butterfly guard where I'm at, right? I can post a hand, scoop, and make a butterfly look. Shin shin. Now I can actually play basically butterfly guard. There's moves where I actually lift and elevate this hook like butterfly. Take it down here. Okay? So I can play that type of guard from this grip, it becomes very hard to pass. So notice our backspin came off of, if this knee pressure's in, boom, I have to backspin, I can't do a single leg, it's too much pressure. That, if I'm here going to put the knee pressure, he's got very hard time putting pressure, okay? I just extend the hook. Then at any point in time, I'm gonna catch here, knee him out this way, and take him right down, okay? There's a bunch of techniques from this position. One of my favorites is just pulling to single leg X when I'm here, okay? Just push this up and through, and right onto the rib here, okay? So again, from here, if you're riding us, I just pull his knee into my chest and straighten it up and through. Okay, single leg X. From here, we've been working our basic takedown, transitioning to other style, overhook X star kick. So we'll work more into these positions on Thursday. But I want us to be aware of can you go to the knees real quick? When I teach from the knees, we call it butterfly, right? And then we have all these same motions, we're doing everything the same. One pose, one pushes, I make my grips. Then if he puts one foot up, I can go between, I'm already playing the positions we were just playing, right? Here, I can spin under, I'm shin to shin. Then if he stands all the way up, now suddenly I'm not butterfly guard, I'm sitting guard, okay? But I want us to define him as something the same, or at least similar. All of our motions are the same. We use our hooks, it thrives on posting a hand to keep him from being put flat to our back, okay? So I just want us to think about that. We're about to do some live drilling, and I want us to live drill with that in mind, that our mobility is the same as butterfly, okay? We use a hand to stop him, we use a hand to move forward, a hand to move back, okay, the same way as butterfly guard. So from here, we're gonna start a live round from a grip, okay? Not a sleeve, we're gonna do it from a lapel or a belt. We're gonna have one person in this position, no footing, okay? This is a little too close to getting something. Just here, grip through, post your hand or not. If he starts to make a lot of knee pressure, I'm gonna go right to my back, okay? So this is where we have to think butterfly guard. So go back up. This is where we have to think of our butterfly principles. This hand, okay, now put the knee pressure. Now I just move. If he puts pressure, I just move. I have a hand, okay? So just like butterfly guard. Okay, then as I'm moving, I can swoop between. Bring me back. Okay? Give you the head ram on that.
That was nice. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah.